Hey guys, Kronegger here.
As suggested by you, today we're gonna talk about the Unkempt Harold. Brace yourself, because this is a weapon that has caused more controversy than pineapple on pizza. A fan favorite since its debut in Borderlands 2, it packs so much power that it makes most other guns look like pea shooters. We'll discuss if this is a good or a bad thing later. But first, let's start with the references. And boy, all the three versions of the pistol are a nod to the movie Dirty Harry.
Fire 6 shots or only 5? Well, to tell you the truth, in all this excitement, I've kind of lost track.
The name, the red text, and even the spread pattern, the whole weapon is a reference. So, what makes the Harold so special? For the one person who doesn't know, the Harold is a high damage, slow fire rate explosive pistol that shoots 7 projectiles. The main projectiles deal 100% splash damage, the additional 70% splash damage. The time the shot splits depends on the accuracy of the gun. The more accurate it is, the later the shots will split. By the way, there is more. The Unkempt Harold has a double penetrative variant, which makes the Harold shoot 2 times more shots, consuming more ammo. Let's remember that the additional projectiles are not listed on the item card, so each receives full amp damage from the B shield. This makes it even more lethal. I mean, why have a well-balanced game when you can just have chaos, right? But for real, this is a must-have weapon for any Vault Hunter who wants to feel like an unstoppable force of destruction. Which raises the question, is a Harold too good for its own good? Well, some people just love the power that comes with this pistol. While other people argue that the Unkempt Harold is unbalanced and terrible because it destroys both the core game cycle, killing, looting, upgrading, and also the endgame boss's design. They say the Harold is an example of how weapon balancing is one of Borderlands 2's weaker aspects. They say it's so powerful that it could give Chuck Norris a run for his money. Okay, maybe not that powerful. But seriously, do you think this is true? I mean, it's not like the Unkempt Harold is hard to come by. It is obtainable in early game, very easy to farm, doesn't take much skill to use, and is a top tier gun with basically any character. And I mean, literally any Harold is OP regardless of the parts. And this is what is fascinating to me. For the same reasons I just mentioned, for some people the Harold is an appealing weapon, and for others it's just plain boring. At the end of the day, it all comes down to a matter of perspective, really. For instance, the main issue I have with this weapon being so good is that it can trivialize Borderlands 2 challenges. I mean, what is the fun in that? But hey, maybe that's just me. What about you? Do you embrace the power, or do you curse the unbalancing nightmare that is the Harold? Although, regardless of where you stand on the Unkempt Harold debate, there is no denying that this weapon has earned its place in the heart of many Vault Hunters. In Borderlands the pre-sequel, we got the 8080 Fragnum. It looks like the Harold, but it feels more like a masher and like a response from Gearbox about how overpowered the Harold was. Unlike the Harold, the Fragnum fires fewer projectiles with high ammo cost. For 3 ammo, it shoots 5 bullets in a broad spread. The double penetrative variant consumes 6 ammo and shoots 8 bullets, which is unique. The 8080 Fragnum has a unique 25% crit damage bonus, and additionally, all the bullets deal 100% splash damage. For better or for worse, it does feel like a nerfed version of the Harold. But don't get me wrong, it's definitely not a bad gun, and it actually benefits a lot from gun actors like Nisha, Claptrap, and the frozen and explosive combination. This weapon can still be devastating. Also, it is still a Dirty Harry reference. Now, let's talk about the Borderlands 3 version. When the game first launched, many players were disappointed that the Harold was not in the game. And it wasn't until many updates later that the Harold finally made its triumphant return. While this is still a powerful weapon, there are some key differences to note. First, the double penetrative variant is gone. However, it can now come in any element, making it a more versatile option than its predecessor. Although there is a new downside, like any other splash damage weapon, it deals self-splash damage.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
There is a 3 pellets and 4 pellets variant, but it was discovered that the 4 pellet variant is not worth having, the reason being that both variants will always split into several projectiles. And I mean, who needs the triple pellet variant when you can have the four pellets variant with less damage and more ammo consumption? It just sounds like a dream. It's also worth mentioning that the Herald received a 100% damage buff, and it's among the best weapons in the game. The Herald, while still being good, it's not the only good option we have, and I think this is the main difference. Due to weapon balancing, Borderlands 2 Herald was extremely powerful compared to other weapons, and in Borderlands 3, the Herald is as powerful as other weapons. So, which version do you think is better? The Borderlands 2 version, which is more unique and more powerful in its own right, the Borderlands pre-sequel one, which is a more balanced version, or the Borderlands 3 version that is still pretty good and offers more versatility. You know, whether you love it or hate it, the Unkempt Harold became a staple in the Borderlands franchise. Who knows, maybe we'll get it again in the next game, and with a triple penetrating variant that can make everything explode, because in Borderlands, anything is possible, except for balance, apparently. And yeah, that's all I have to say about the Herald. Let me know in the comments if I forgot anything to say. Leave a like and subscribe if you liked the video, and if you didn't, well, leave a like as well. That's how it works, I swear. Bye bye.